Isn't Flow Forming just cast, bro?
Okay, now, stop.
So definitely not. This is like saying that rubber is the same thing as tires, and cows are the same thing as hamburgers, and cotton is the same thing as t-shirts. Just because something has the same origin doesn't mean that it's the same final product. And we're going to explain the difference between a flow form wheel and a traditional cast wheel coming up after this sweet intro. What's going on? I'm Scott from Koenig, and before we get into this video, if you wouldn't mind throwing us a like and subscribing down below. So to be able to explain to you the difference between a traditional cast wheel and a flow form wheel, we have to start with a definition of each.
Okay, apparently I'm a cartoon now. Flow forming is when you take a wheel and cast it to a narrower width than the desired final product, then pressure is applied to the barrel of the wheel while spinning under heat to stretch and compress the aluminum, increasing the strength. Hey, Dowd, hit him off with that casting definition. Feels weird in here.
Here it comes.
Molten metal is injected into a mold. As the metal cools, the wheel becomes strong and rigid.
Both do come from a mold, which means that they're both casted. However, what happens after that process is really what's important. When it comes down to casting, there are different types of casting. And there's low pressure, high pressure, and gravity, tilt, and pour. You've seen these different types of terms thrown around, and each one does have a pro and con. However, they're all kind of somewhat similar on the playing field. You'll have a lot of people that will talk about low pressure being far superior than a gravity, but again, it's very, very marginal, and most of the benefits that you'll experience really are on the factory end or the shipping end, and less on the strength end. So now when it comes down to flow forming essentially has the same origin. So it's that same type of casting process. And again, there's different types of casting which can certainly go along with the flow forming process. Where flow forming becomes different is what happens after the mold. Now, to start, the molds for a flow forming wheel are going to be different. And the reason is because the final product of a flow form mold allows the wheel to come out of the mold than a narrower width than you will see on the finished product. So for example, maybe you want an 18 by 10.5. That may come out of the mold in an 18 by 7, and the rest is going to be part of the flow forming process. And this is why they're not the same. What they do with a flow forming wheel after is they basically start to spin the wheel under heat, and they use dies to essentially grab the barrel of the wheel and begin pushing it and extruding it out. Now what happens during that process is a structure change. The molecular structure of the wheel actually changes, and that's what makes the barrel of the wheel so much stronger. Because we're making that barrel stronger, because we're compressing the molecules of the aluminum and we're tightening up the grain structure, we're actually going to increase the tensile strength of the wheel. And when we do that, we're going to be able to use less material. And that's why a flow form wheel, especially as we go wider, is going to weigh less than a traditional cast design. Now, all these processes not only have a material cost, but they have a time cost. And this is why, when you start to compare wheels, there becomes a different price point. Of course, there's going to be some marketing things in that between brands, but when we really start to talk about the price point, a cast wheel has less time to finish the product than a flow form wheel. Because we talked about the flow form wheel now coming out of the mold, then it has to go through that flow forming process, which takes a good amount of time compared. And then at that point, then it has to go through the finishing stages. So right there, you've already seen a big change in how much time it takes to produce that wheel. The same thing happens when we talk about a forged wheel. First, the aluminum has to be put into a 10,000 ton press. After that's done, it needs to be a CNC'd. CNC'ing a design takes a long time. So again, we understand that there's definitely a material cost, but there's also a very big time cost that comes into each finalized product. And that's where you start to get the difference between all three stages. So flow forming really is the best bang for the buck. And we've talked about this plenty. If you have any budget at all and you need extra strength or you want to reduce the weight of your vehicle, going with a flow form wheel is a great option.
Worth is right. It's my money and I need it now.
So going back to the original point of this video, isn't a flow form wheel the same as a cast wheel? Now we've already explained to you the differences in process, but let's talk about the advantages. The advantages over a traditional cast wheel are pretty great. The wheel is lighter, and that's because we're able to use less material in the barrel as we compress the aluminum and extrude out that barrel. It's stronger because we're able to compress the aluminum and change the grain structure. The wheel has more tensile strength. A flow foam wheel is much stronger, on average about 30% stronger. The wheel has more elongation, and what that is how much a wheel can bend before it would reach a catastrophic breaking point. But it also allows the wheel to have that flex. And when you have that flex, because we're talking about metal, not magic, that's gonna allow the wheel to essentially return to its original shape after suffering an impact. So that's a major benefit. It's gonna have a greater shock resistance, so it's gonna be able to really take an impact much better than a traditional cast wheel. And another benefit that you must consider is the budget, because this flow form wheel will cost less than a forged wheel. And while it costs more than a traditional cast wheel, there's a lot of benefits that come with it. So if you're gonna end up using this wheel in motorsport, this is something you really need to consider, and it's a great midpoint. So hopefully this quick summary helped you see the difference between a traditional cast wheel and a flow form wheel. If you still have any questions, throw them down below. We'll be happy to answer them. Till then, we will catch you on the next one.